Before we can dive into the many powerful features and functions of Word 2013, we first need to launch the program and get comfortable in our environment. So let's explore the user interface by first launching Word 2013. Now what you see very beginning here, this is our start screen, and down left hand side you will see a color coded area. And you see a list of your recent work on file. So you have quick access to them. If you want to go back, you also have a link to open other documents. So allowing you to browse your computer and online. To the right, we have a number of templates, including the default templates, which is our blank documents. If you're looking for a template that does not show up here on this initial screen, you can search for templates online, and there are thousands to search through. Here are also some suggested search to help you get start as well. If you are logged in already to our Microsoft account, you will see that informations on top right corner. You can switch to another account, or perhaps you share your computer. Top right corner, you will see a button getting help. F1 is a keyboard shortcut, a minimize button, maximize and a close button to close Word 2013 altogether. Now the default template is a blank document, so let's go there. I just simply click one. Now this launch is Word to the initial user interface that you will see once you get past that start screen over here. Our left hand side is our navigation pane. If your document has headings, you won't go through page or results, you can search quickly using this navigation pane. You can also close up using the close button, and you can view at any time from the view tab on the ribbon. Let's move up to the top of the screen. You saw the quick access toolbar. You see some buttons there by default, like the save, undo, and you also saw repeat option here as well. And then the drop down, or you can pick and choose what going to show up your quick access toolbar. Anything with check mark is already showing. You can remove them by clicking them, or you can add item as well. We go back, that is later lesson. Right below that is our ribbon. Of course, file tab is actually going to take it to our backstage view. So let's go there now. Let's take us to a different view with a list of options down left hand side for opening, saving, creating new documents, printing, exporting, etc. You can also access our Word options down here. The very button, you can go back to recent documents. Go to your SkyDrive account, and with your Windows accounts, you do get some free space there, and of course you could purchase more if you needed to, but it's a great way to save your documents to the cloud, so you have anytime, anywhere access to them. You can also browse your computer to open file there. Even add places little shortcut, it will take you directly other location. If you want to, there also a back button up here, so we can click the back button to go backward. We start before we click the file tab. Next is ribbon in you, and you see the home tab is highlighted or selected by default. So we were looking at various section here, the clipboard, font section. There is many of these arrows icon in the button right corner, so you can actually expand these and get full dialog boxes. You have quick access to style, but you can also go to the full styles dialog by clicking the arrow in the button right corner of that section. Let's just quickly go through some other tabs. If you need to insert objects into your documents, go to the insert tab, and again it's broken up into a category. So pages, tables, illustrations, etc. Under design, we have no of design options, and here you get into various documents formatting and options and color schemes, etc. Page layout, reference, mailings, review and view. At the very end at the view tab is going to show your default view, which is our print layout view. We'll be taking about the different views in upcoming lessons, but for now just notice that the print layout is the default view, and that's the default view you might be used to from various of versions of Microsoft Word as well. Go back to home tab. Also, if you have long documents, you're going to see scroll bar over here on right hand side. You can scroll through your pages if your documents to wide scroll bar will appear across the button, a horizontal one, and then down at the very bottom. We have on the status bar some informations. You can see where page 1 of 1, 0 words so far. There is a word count that shows up there, and also on right hand side, those view mode we just show from view top available to us here. So you have read mode, the one that selected print layout as well as web layout, and then you have our zoom slider. So we can use the negative sign and the positive sign to zoom in and zoom out of our document, or we can click and drag slider. Such a quick tour of our user interface here in Word 2013. Now we are comfortable our environment, it's time to little more exploring and start getting into some other features and functions available to here in Word 2013. So friends, that's all for today. We will meet again in next video. Till then, bye.